speech that Sushma Swaraj gave in 1996 after Atal Bihari Vajpayee, you know, had to resign. And in that speech, she had mentioned that whole divide about secularism and communalism. In fact, in that speech, she had mentioned the abolition of Article 370 as one of the core agendas of the BJP. And last evening, before the sudden news came in, her last tweet was also on Article 370 being revoked by the current government led by Narendra Modi. And she had, in fact, very hauntingly said that this is what she was waiting for in her lifetime, and she passed away soon after. She really stood for her ideals, whether you like it or you don't like it. Sushma Swaraj always stood for the ideology that she believed in.
You know, it's a personal loss for me. I have worked with her in the Rajya Sabha. She was like a sister to me, mm-hmm. and I know that she represented the best that is there in Indian woman. She was at the same time a Durga, a Kali, a Saraswati. She, when it required to be a Kali, she could be a Kali. When she needed to be a Durga, she could be a Durga. And when it came to her knowledge, her understanding of things, she could be a Saraswati. So I could see a perfect Indian woman, a mother, a sister, a daughter, and a woman of substance in her. So her loss is a loss for the whole nation, and this loss we can never forget. And she had one quality that she knew when to rise above party politics. She stood for her party. She very strongly, you know, protected the party, represented the party, but when it required to be, she could rise above party differences, she could rise above ideological differences, and that's what made her so popular among cutting across all ideological divides. And she was not only articulate, she was not only very good with words, she was also very logical. She was also full of, you know, she was always very factual. Aur Urdu zuban pe, Hindi zuban bhashaon pe, unka pura gyan tha. Mujhe maloom hai ki Urdu ke sher unhe itne yaad the ki main kabhi utne sher yaad nahi kar sakta hu. Har occasion ke liye unke paas sher rehta tha maujood. To ye unki quality thi. She was, as I said, ki wo Durga bhi thi, वो काली भी थी, वो सरस्वती भी थी. आर्टिकल 370 की जहां तक बात है, यकीनन वो
उनका एक्सर्ट फ्रॉम द 1990
सपना था और वो सपना पूरा हुआ है जी. सपना पूरा हुआ है.
मैं उसी बात पे वापस आना चाहती हूं शायद सिद्दीकी, बट आई डू वांट टू प्ले दैट एक्सर्ट.
पूरा हुआ उनका.
आई जस्ट वांट टू प्ले दैट एक्सर्ट फ्रॉम द 1996 स्पीच शायद सिद्दीकी. आई कम बैक टू यू राइट आफ्टर दैट.
अध्यक्ष जी, हम सांप्रदायिक हैं. हाँ 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 हाँ, हम सांप्रदायिक हैं क्योंकि हम वंदे मातरम गाने की वकालत करते हैं. हम सांप्रदायिक हैं क्योंकि हम राष्ट्रीय ध्वज के सम्मान के लिए लड़ते हैं. अपने वोट बैंक को खुश करने के लिए निर्दोष राम भक्तों को गोलियों से भूनने वाले ये सपा वाले सेकुलर हैं. चकमा शरणार्थियों को भगाने वाले और घुसपैठियों को बसाने की वकालत करने वाले ये वामपंथी सेकुलर हैं. सच्चाई तो ये है अध्यक्ष जी, महसूस नहीं करते आपको इन तथाकथित बुद्धिजीवियों से सेकुलर होने का सर्टिफिकेट नहीं।
Remarkable conviction with which Sushma Swaraj spoke every time she spoke, always stood true to what she believed. Shahid Siddiqui, when are you ever going to hear a more fiery speech than that? You know, despite ideological differences, Sushma Swaraj really voiced everything that she believed in that day. And it is amazing how true it holds to today, more than 20 years ago later.
And let me tell you that when she said, haan, hum sampradayak hain, but I know that I have not known another person who was as secular as Sushma Swaraj. She never differentiated between a Hindu and a Muslim or a Sikh or a Christian. She, as an external affairs minister, she helped more Muslims than Hindus ever. She was more sympathetic. She worked more for the minorities than anyone else. Whether as the chief minister of Delhi, whether as information minister, she was always above religious divide. And so when she says, haan, hum sampradayak hain, I know that she is not. She is the last person to be sampradayak. She is a totally, thoroughly secular person in her personal life, in her beliefs, in her thinking.
And therefore, she was hitting at the fact that there is this element of fake secularism, especially in Indian politics, which condemns BJP as communal. Yes. But what is the definition of that communalism?
Absolutely. And she was telling them that, look, you call us communal, but in reality, you are communal. So she could, you know, hit back with so much force that the opposition did not know where to hide. And every word she uttered was with so much of conviction. I have been witness to so many of her speeches in last 20, 30 years. I have known her for last 30 years personally as well as politically. And I can say that she was a woman of conviction, a woman who believed in India and who believed in the women of India. She was the ideal woman for Indian women who stood up and showed them that a woman could rise. She hardly ever spoke in English. Even in United Nations, she spoke in Hindi. And she showed that with the language of Hindi, with the command of Hindi, she could be better than the best of English-speaking people. For knowledge, for understanding, you don't have to speak in English. You don't have to read in English. You don't have to understand in English. You can do all that by understanding and knowing Hindustani. And that she did. So in many, many ways, she was one of the best leaders independent India has produced today, not only as a woman, I'm saying generally as a leader, she is one of the best that India has produced.
Yes. Absolutely. And therefore, this is such a huge loss for the BJP, isn't it, Shahid Siddiqui, as a political commentator? This is another brick of that old school wall, if I may say that, that is slowly slipping away. You know, that era that is slowly slipping away. The BJP, politically speaking, hasn't seen better days. Narendra Modi winning a second successive term. Who would have thought when Atal Bihari Vajpayee came to power as the first NDA Prime Minister? But they've lost Atal Bihari Vajpayee in the last few years. Manohar Parikar and now Sushma Swaraj. You know, very, very deep losses for the party.
Sushma Swaraj was the leader of opposition in the Rajya Sabha. She was the leader of opposition in the Lok Sabha. She was holding the fort in the worst times of BJP, difficult times of BJP, when BJP was being surrounded and attacked. So she has seen the worst times of BJP, best time many people can rise. And let me tell you, the day she came to know that she is not going to be in the cabinet, within a week, she vacated her official bungalow in times when after 5 years, 10 years, 20 years, ministers are not ready to vacate their bungalows. She vacated the bungalow and moved to her very small flat on Jantar Mantar Road. And I met her 2 days back for a lunch, and she invited me to her house. And just now I have returned from that house. I never knew that I'll go to that house, but in such tragic circumstances. She said, aa jao humare ghar, ab ghar set ho gaya hai. Kabad humne ek taraf kar diya, saman bahut tha, but come. And I thought that I'll be going this week, and now I went there in such tragic days, and it's such a shock for all of us who knew her, who loved her.
Absolutely. Shahid Siddiqui, I just want to play some of the reactions that we've also gathered from several leaders across political lines. Everyone has paid their rich tributes to Sushma Swaraj. Let's just listen into a few of those.